call them Lou's.
Hey, Lou.
The regular?
Yeah, the regular.
Coming right up.
Whiskey neat.
Thanks, Lou.
Detective Druff, didn't expect to see you here. After everything that happened, last I heard you were in Evanston somewhere.
Is that what they're saying now? Probably something around the lines that I ran away from my responsibilities, my job, all the way up to Evanston.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to bring up such awful memories. I had no idea neurology residents could
Don't
be so-
Don't worry about it, doll. All right? Third year, neither you nor I can change what that rotation did.
I gotta be straight with you, Druff. That's actually the reason why I'm here. You know, things have never been the same since you left. The rotations have gone from bad to worse, and the Pritzker students, they're running scared, Druff. They need you.
Let's get this straight. No one needs me anymore, and the Pritzker students, they'll continue to be scared, no matter what I do or what anyone else does. Because at the end of the day, the attendings, the residents, the medical students, they may all change from rotation to rotation, but let me tell you something. The wards, they never change.
I don't think you understand what I'm saying, Druff. This isn't some resident mistreatment case that just gets swept under the rug. I'm talking about the gunslinging bandit. And he's got Viktor.
The gunslinging bandit is a myth. I tried to track him down during my second year, came up with nothing. You think that now, broken, washed up, that I'm going to be able to find the biggest gunner in Pritzker history? I don't think so.
This isn't the Woody Druff I met 4 years ago at Revisit. He would never stand for this. His own man gunned down on his ward?
Well, that's because that Woody Druff is gone.
Well, Victor's being held in a building off Ellis, if you decide to change your mind. And for everyone's sake, I hope you do.
Victor.
Druff? I have to say, Druff, no one carries the smell of bourbon and cheap cigarettes quite like you. I would shake your hand, but as you can see, I'm a bit preoccupied.
That's actually what I want to talk with you about, Victor. I have a couple questions about your medicine rotation.
Yeah, exactly. My medicine rotation. That's precisely why I have no time to talk to you. I have to be studying for my shelf exam. I'm carrying 7 patients right now. I have to get up at 3 in the morning to prepare 4 rounds. I don't have time for this.
Victor, I don't know how to say this, but your medicine rotation ended 4 months ago. Someone locked you in the bathroom while you were trying to take a dump before rounds.
No.
And you failed the rotation.
Failed? No, that's ludicrous. That's impossible. No. How could I have failed? I'm on my medicine rotation right now. I mean, why am I wearing a white coat right now? Why am I going to rounds tomorrow? I know who put you up to this. It was Connie. You and Connie are in on this together. You're trying to gun me down. You're just jealous. You're jealous because when I was on my neurology rotation, the residents liked me more.
What do you say about neurology?
Druff, no! Fly, you fool!
Druff, are you paying attention? I need you in this. Druff, are you paying attention? I need you in this.
I don't know, guys. I think that resident saw us. Can we really sneak out of rounds like this?
Stefan, get it together. Do you want to go back and round for another 10 hours? That's where we're going.
Guys,
that's
guys, where we're going. Guys. It's one of the Norhal's residents. Do you think he saw us?
Oh, go, go, go.
Priestess, it's been too long. Didn't know that the goal of Humanism Society had become such a covert operation.
We're not here to play games, Druff. We want answers.
If you think for a second that I'm the gunslinging bandit, then you're about as lost as one of those first-year students wandering the wards of Mitchell.
Watch it, Druff! That's the High Priestess.
Druff, you can't just waltz back into Hyde Park and talk to Viktor and not expect to turn heads. Where were you the night of the incident?
You all know where I went after my neurology rotation.
Does he have an alibi?
You have to check my pocket.
Does it check out?
It's an EM shift card. Can't make that up.
All right, Jeff. I'm not sure it's the right thing to do, but I'm going to trust you. Leviathan, brief him on incident 1099.
So is this, the Covenant Spymaster of the Gold Humanism Society? An agent said to have stores of tea on people so great that it rivaled only that of the old East India? Well, I have to say, I'm not impressed. Also, Leviathan is a stupid nickname, too. What are you looking at over there?
Nobody else. Let's see here. Cold. Stubborn. Constantly tardy.
Yeah, sounds about right. Probably it was Mark Angelo who said that one.
Well, yes, psychiatry, but also family medicine. Then surgery, and internal medicine. Oh, but look here, pediatrics. They quite liked you, didn't they?
I don't know nothing about that didn't happen.
Oh, are you sure?
Yeah, no, I'm positive.
Let's see here, it says, Druff was a joy to have on the wards. He really advocated for the kiddos. We talk to them frequently about business.
All right, Leviathan. I get the point. What do you need me to do?
Since Viktor's attack, we've been focusing a lot of our energies here at the Gold Humanism Society to figuring out who did it.
The gunslinging bandit, right?
Oh, no, Druff. I would have expected better of you than to listen to petty rumors. No, it's a sleeper cell of Northwestern students infiltrating the Pritzker wards in an attempt to destabilize our ranking.
Well, then what do you want me to do about it?
What we want you to do is to do your job.
We'll be in touch.
Well, maybe I could have done my job if you all hadn't kidnapped me like this.
Tell me, Druff. What did those stiffs down at the Gold Humanism Society want to talk to you about?
It's nonsense as usual, McKillop. It's good to see you, partner. I haven't seen you since our case of the off-campus Misty Greens. How you been?
Been good. Moved up to Wisconsin after you left. Settled in at a clinic by the countryside. This place gives me a bad taste in my mouth. It's like somebody's memory of a town. The memory is fading.
So then, what brought you back?
Can't lie to you, Druff. Leviathan called in a favor. Gotta help her with some unsolved gunnings. You know what I'm talking about.
The Northwestern students, right?
No, old friend. I'm talking about our old nemesis, the gunslinging bandit.
Leviathan told me the gunslinging bandit was a myth.
And you think she was giving it to you straight? Leviathan doesn't know who to trust anymore. She thinks there might be a mole in the Gold Humanism Society.
So is that why you're back, McKillop? Partner up for one last ride?
You know I'd want nothing more than to help you out with this one, Druff. But after those nights on Obi-Gyne, I don't know if these bones have it in me anymore. Can tell you one thing, though. With Leviathan's resources, I was able to track down the names of a few men who were on the wards the day that Viktor was locked in the bathroom.
Thanks, Mikkel. I always know I can count on you.
You can count on me. But if you're going to do this one, Druff, you're going to do it alone. You can't count on the top brass in the administration to get themselves dirty in the muck and solve this one. This is a world where nothing is solved. You know, someone once told me that time is a flat circle. And everything we've done or will do, we're going to do it again. And the gunslinging bandit, well, they're going to keep gunning and gunning again and again. In eternity, nothing can grow. Nothing becomes. Nothing changes. So death created time to grow the things that it would kill. What do you think, Druff? Druff?
It all started with an idea, a desire, deep within my soul. I wanted to become the best medical student. By sabotaging the rest, I started with a couple gunnings here and there during first and second year. But what it did, it created an environment of fear in which medical students were too afraid to show up to the ward. And when all the medical students are too afraid to show up to rounds, I'll be there. And when all the medical students are too afraid to volunteer at the free clinics, I'll be there. And when the administration is looking for someone to name the best medical student of the year, they only have one obvious choice, Santiago Diaz.
Oh, Diaz.
Yes.
I didn't expect you to defeat them so easily. Draft friend, what do you say? We can rule Pritzker together, you and me, hand in hand. Granted, I'll be slightly above you, but you'll be in the spotlight nonetheless.
You see, Santiago, that's the thing that you've never understood. I only have one mistress, and her name is Justice.
You're making a mistake, Druff. What are you gonna do about it? Are you gonna report me to Holly Humphrey?
Something like that.